I always say it's for two Davids. Right? For
ele, David sempre fala, ele sempre fala que é para os dois Davi. O David Sambor.
Yeah, and David, el rey, King David.
Da Bíblia.
Eu, Davi da Bíblia.
O rei Davi. Que legal, cara.
O rei Davi.
But David Sanborn was very, very kind to me when I was a young musician.
Oh, so David Sanborn foi muito bom para ele quando ele estava começando a carreira solo.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Ajudou muito ele.
Yeah, very, very. And even now, you know, he's very. He says to me, he says.
Até hoje ele diz para ele.
There's only one of you.
Só tem um dele.
That's and I'm going like.
Só tem Kirk Whalen que ele diz.
Yeah. So that was very encouraging. Yeah. So that you know it's God.
Um encorajamento que ele deu para ele.
Yeah, you know it's God, right? Just all God.
Colocar as pessoas certas no lugar certo, né? Put the right people in at the right place so you can.
Yes, you know, not only that, but also like the impact that you have on people and on musicians.
O impacto que você tem com as pessoas tocando música.
Like you can.
Você pode
prepare and practice.
Se preparar e treinar.
And you should.
E você deve fazer isso.
Right? But still,
mas ainda,
the impact
o impacto que você tem que causar nas pessoas vem de Deus. É por isso que as pessoas te reconhecem, porque pela música eles sentem a presença de Deus.
And people like David Sanborn, they're not naturally following God. And so when they hear something in you, they go.
Something different.
There's something different.
Yeah.
You know,
there's a light.
A
light.
One day I was playing. There's a sax player, a very good sax player in Brazil.
Mm.
And he told it to me.
Mm.
He was not Christian.
Mm-hmm.
So, and he saw me playing.
Mm-hmm.
He saw something different.
Yeah, and he said, "What? What do you study?"
Mm.
I have football. I study
the scales.
And he said to me, "I study too,
mm-hmm.
but there's something different."
Yeah,
when you play,
and at that time, the Holy Spirit said to me, "It's my spirit.
Yeah.
It's very good. It's very good."
And see, then they go,
It's a mystery from God.
Yes.
On one side, it's like it's so beautiful, but I also see in the church,
yes,
many young musicians who they know that it's the Spirit of God is the power, but they are not willing to do the work.
Tem muitos músicos que conhecem a presença de Deus, experimentou a presença de Deus e conhecem que existe algo dentro deles que é melhor do que aquilo que eles estão fazendo, mas eles não querem ter o trabalho de estudar a técnica do instrumento.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, that to me is like, I mean, yes, absolutely. God can speak through someone who doesn't have,
absolutamente,
you know, training, who doesn't have access to. To training.
Yeah, absolutamente. Deus pode te usar e fluir dentro de você, mas a capacidade técnica
have to study,
acompanhar,
yeah,
acompanhar os estudos e ensinamentos que você toca.
There's a writer named what's his name? See, the book is called Outliers. You know this book, Outliers?
Yeah.
By
Outliers.
Carlos Maxwell, maybe.
It's
a Christian book.
Malcolm Gladwell. Malcolm Gladwell. Okay, so this book is called Outliers. So outlier is a word that means those people over here, right? Outliers. So you have all people.
Yeah.
But then you sometimes have someone who's different. It's an outlier. You know what I mean by outlier?
Yeah, I understand that. Num grupo de pessoas, você pode ter uma multidão de pessoas dentro desse ciclo, né? E quando você tem a percepção do outlier, quando você está dentro desse grupo de pessoas, mas você tem uma pessoa que é única e diferente daquelas outras pessoas.
Yeah.
Isso faz você ser o diferenciador da multidão. Você está dentro da multidão, mas você faz a diferença
Da
multidão.
Mas and that's a big group of people. Every single one has a gift from God.
Yeah, dentro dessa multidão de pessoas, cada um tem um talento de Deus dentro deles, né?
But the outlier is the one who is willing to spend at least 10,000 hours
to mastery
preparation,
mastery the skills.
That's it.
Yes. You know, the outlier is the one. The outlier, falando a palavra em inglês que não tem a tradução em português, outlier, a palavra outlier é aquela pessoa que recebe o chamado de Deus, aquela pessoa que tem o fluir de Deus e aquela pessoa que está dentro da multidão e pelo talento que ela percebeu, o talento que ela reconheceu que ela tem, ele vai daí, desse talento, ele vai buscar o conhecimento técnico, o conhecimento prático e juntar os dois e daí fazer
10,000 hours.
Com 10 mil horas de estudos.
Okay, so in this book he says that you have this line here, and so
nesse livro tem uma linha.
All the people who are not willing to spend the time, they know they have a gift from God, but not spending the time, not following, asking questions, not studying. But over here, above the line, is the one who is spending
willing to
10,000 hours.
Yes.
And then after that 10,000 hours, you're still...
Bishop talk about this, Bishop Brunner.
Okay.
That, you know, God gives you a gift, but it's up to you to take that gift, and it's up to you
work.
To master that gift. But according to his theory, it takes 10,000 hours for you to master a skill.
Yes, yes.
Bishop Brunner, da igreja que eu te levei, o Bishop fala sobre isso.